Let's simply start off with the fingers and let's breathe out and lift up overhead. And exhale, slide down the heart. Breathe up to the sky. Go wide and clear your energy field. Breathe up. Exhale, humbly slide down the heart line. Breathe up. Exhale, wide. And again, lift up. Exhale, humbly slide down the heart line. And inhale up. Exhale, go out and wide. And easy, bring your hands onto your knees. Relax the shoulders. Kind of shake out the head. You're going to make your tongue into a little taco. Or if that's impossible, then you pretend you're sucking in on a straw. And you breathe in through your mouth, through the taco or through the mouth, through the straw. And you exhale through the nose. Om one, two, three. Draw in the breath. Exhale the warm breath out through the nose. Two, three. Breathe in through the taco. Breathe out through the nose. Breathe into the navel point. Cool breath in. Warm breath out. Empty. Draw in. Exhale. Breathe in. Breathe out through the nose. Breathe in. Breathe out through the nose. Cool breath. Exhale through the nose. Breathe in through the taco. Breathe out through the nose. Three more. Breathe in, cool breath. Draw it in. Hi, David. Breathe out through the nose. Cool breath in. Out through the nose. Breathe in through the taco. Cool breath. Exhale through the nose. Float the arms out, up and overhead. Inhale. Take in a little bit extra breath. Hold the breath, stretch, contract, swallow, reach, and humbly slide down the heart line. Let's dedicate this breath and this practice to the illumination, to the coolness, the softening of the fevers. Dedicate the breath to being oil on the water, smoothing the chop. And we can dedicate this breath and this practice to California's gratitude. Slide the hands on down, go outside legs, fold in, stretch the legs out because we've been here. Hi, David, nice to see you. Everything okay? Good. And cross the other leg. Let's reach out, inhale, lift up. And exhale, slide on down. Hold on to the knees and spin the torso around the pelvic bowl. You can open the elbows up, David, a little bit so you get a lot of room for the ribs to spin. He's watching you. And then circle the other direction, massaging the waist, stretching out the lower back, invigorating the kidneys. Easy into the center, arms up and overhead. Exhale off to the right side and just pulse three times. Three more times. Feels good. Elbows over the ear. Easy. Rise on up and happy cactus. And then spin to the right and dive on down over that knee. Remember, the hands go on either side of the knee. You try and make a T with your shoulders, considering that the thigh would be the base of the letter. Torque the body, relax and bow down over the right knee, over the right thigh. Breathe into your back, breathe into that spiraling action, those muscles. And then easy, let's Michi march around and come up nice and tall. Take that left arm back behind you, the right hand to the outside of the thigh. Stretch, then lengthen the spine, roll the shoulders, and look over your left shoulder. Breathing in and breathing out. Massaging the inner body, moving the ribs. Easy, spin around, back into the center, shimmy and shake. And sweep the arms out, up and overhead, rise up. Exhale, slide down the heart line, dedicating this breath to your sweet, kind and radiant self. To the practice of your discipline of participating in a yoga, the union, the joining, the yoga. That unity, that community. Slide the hands down. Let's just shift the feet. You know, many of us are really missing our Bhakti Fest celebrations, which were always in the first 2 weeks of September for 10, 11 years. And so on Facebook, there's all these wonderful gatherings popping up and everybody's really having a strong look at what COVID has changed in all of us and where our yearning is for gathering. So I really appreciate all of you showing up and being part of this Zoom, which is as close as we seem to be able to get, and in person when it's possible. So it really matters. It matters to the tribe. Hands go out, three breaths. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, down. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. Inhale, hold the arms up, stretch up, and let that left hand go down off the side, off your hip, not too far behind you. Stay off the diagonal, 45 degrees, somewhere in that mid-range between the outside thigh and the outside hip. Good. Keeping the chin up and good. Careful you don't run into the bedboard. Good. Three more. One, two, three, easy, rebound up, happy cactus, spin, spin, spin. Find that freedom, that looseness. And then to the left, and then dive on down. Nice and wide, crown of the head towards the left knee. Roll a little bit forward so that the actual outside of your legs are providing your triangular base. Torque the shoulders. Drop the head down to the knee. Good job. Elbows are up. Create the space. Lay your heart down on the thigh. That's good. Oh. Nice. You can feel it. Yes. Say yes. And then easy, let's go ahead and Breathe in and Michi march around. Use your fingertips. Take your right hand and come around behind you. Take your left hand on the knee. Roll the shoulders. Lengthen the spine. Spiral that upper thoracic spine so you're looking over your right shoulder. Eyes are wide. Eyeballs in the edge of the sockets. Breath full. Really paying attention to the movement, the buoyancy of your breath, the largeness of your breath. And then easy, let's go ahead and slide the hands around into the front, shimmy and shake. Good, and sweep the arms out, up and overhead. Inhale. And let's humbly just gather the energy and dedicate this breath to our mind, to our sweet spirit, our communication and open listening with the divine. Slide the hands on down. Let's fold the knees in. Let's just go ahead and open the feet out. Change the shape of the thighs, the angle of your bones, so that the feet are wide and the knees are together, and chest is up. And let's windshield wipe. Continuing to encourage the movement of the synovial fluid, that lubrication of the joints, ball and socket joints. See if you can loosen and crack your back. And let's go off to the left side. Bring the hands easy and move that thigh. Move that right rump. Good. And then easy, take that left hand back around behind you, spin the right arm around, lift up, and then slowly inch that right leg out and away from your body so you have a nice opening through your lower gut. You can feel the inner thigh working. You can raise up onto that left shin, reach through your fingers, move your toes, just elongate and create space in your vessel. And then down we come and easy drag that right leg so the soles of the feet are together. The traditional ta-da, careful of the bed, and slide your hands on down. Take the hands, push the knees together, open up the feet, windshield wipe, wipers. They sure don't last down here, windshield wipers. The time you windshield wipe, it just makes the windows dirtier. Spinning side to side. Spin off to the right side. And easy. Slide your hands a little closer to you. You can sit up, and even the dropping of that left sit bone creates some sensation in your thigh. So let's lean back a little bit so we get that length across the top of the left thigh. That movement, that's good. It's getting, what's that night? Boogie fever, boogie nights. it was so much more fun than dancing to rap. Ah, easy breathe. And then settle down, take that right hand back, spin the left arm around. Make sure you look thoroughly, spiral the spine, reaching through the left fingertips. And when you're ready, you can stretch that left leg out far and away from you. Sometimes you can feel the ball and socket joint kind of adjust itself. Often you can feel an opening in your lower pelvis, your lower gut, kind of where the old appendix or, well, where your liver, where your gallbladder, depends which side you're working, sorry. Stretch those intestines, rise up, wiggle your toes, and then roll on down, grab that leg, soles of the feet together, and ta-da! And fold the legs together, stretch them out. So Will, can you hear the music? Oh, good. So this is Donna DeLore. She was Madonna's backup singer. Segued into a very uplifting and fun kirtan, bhajan, communal singing music. So it's kind of a, you can dance to this one. Lift your arms up overhead and bow down. Forward bend, the simplicity of a forward bend, that position of the witness, the opportunity to remove the distractions, to gaze within. If you need to rock a little bit side to side, do that. Good. Relax your shoulders, Fred. Your hands can rest on your legs or on the carpet. You're down to the ground, David. And then easy slide the hands back by the knees. Lift the chest, toes to the nose. Be sure those toes have some circulation going. And then point the toes, activate that midline, open the top of the arch of the foot. There you go. You look like Jesus. You have all this light behind you, David. Well, so some form of Jesus. He was in a scene, you know. Push the heels. They loved almonds and dates. Pull the little toes towards your ears. Remind me, Susan, when you come down, dates. Yeah. We have some homemade dates, homemade pick dates. I just got a box of them from Right Local. You have to lug them home. Open the top of the feet, midlines pull it together. Once more, push the heels. And easy, let's drop the hands. Stack the vertebra, sweep the arms up and overhead, and exhale, fold over. Undulate up, inhale, exhale, bow down. Inhale, reach up, smell the roses, blow out the candles. Inhale, reach up, exhale, inhale up. And again, twice more, one. And two. Once more. Three. Inhale, hold the arms up. Hands by the side, open the feet. Jump up onto all fours. Shake out the moneymaker. Very important to keep the moneymaker strong. Thighs strong, feet grounded. Hands grounded, shoulders rolled, viscera exposed, right knee to the chest, stretch the right leg and roll the foot on the ankle, keep breathing. Lower down, left leg up, roll the foot, keep breathing. Lower down, nice and open, one more breath, strong arms. Head comes up, tail comes down. Wrap your arms in, drop your forehead to your knees. Hold the knees. Drop the forehead to your knees. And easy. Let's swing the legs and roll over onto all fours and find your child's pose. Oh, it's so pleasant. The weather has, I think we're headed into fall. You hold on to that frost for us up there in Quebec. Is that where you are, Quebec? No? Montreal? I have no idea where it is. I only have been to Canada once. Somewhere it's colder than here. Big toes touch. Open the knees out. See if you can walk yourself out and lay down. Stretch your arms a little further, Will. That's good. Just find yourself in that bow down position to the gods. Bow down to the earth. Is your ankle okay, David? Be careful. Good. Take a nice deep breath. Easy. Heads below the heart. Energy in the nestles in the base of your spine, circulates up towards the pineal gland in the middle of your brain. That surrender through the body, that softening of the back, the expansion of the back lungs. Let's dig the fingertips in and lift the wrists. Shimmy and shake the elbows. And go ahead and lay your hands on down flat. And easy, rise on up to all fours. So you're in cat and cow. I just lost my thing. Cat and cow, flip and open, close and open. Swing the buns around the heels. And reverse the circle, massaging from the inside, letting the breath flow freely through you as you navigate your freedom, right? And coming to the center and just wag your tail and wag your head. And great. Hands are nice, like big paws. Thumbs reach towards each other. Wiggle out the elbows and squeeze the elbow creases towards each other. Shoulders are down, left leg straight behind you. Stay engaged with the strength of your arms. Left leg behind you. I guess I should have had you on the ground first, sorry. And then lift the left leg to hip height. And then turn your head and watch that left leg rotate forward so you can see your toes. Keep the arms straight. Really use the strength. And then spiral that left leg back. You know where this goes. Down on the ground. Lift the chest. Look over your right shoulder. See if you can see your heel. Oh, it just feels so good. And then easy, swing that leg back around, bring it towards the front of the left hip, down it goes on the ground, float the left arm up to the sky. Stack your shoulders, turn your head and look at your right hand and see if that shoulder has gone skewy. Roll that shoulder away from your ear, use your armpit, create space in your neck. And lower that hand on down. Center yourself, lift the left leg, swing it back behind you, and the right arm comes up next to your ear. Good, straight forward, David. That's good. Drop your head just a little bit, Fred. Lift the arm a little bit higher. Stretch strong on that arm on the ground. Now thrill seek if you wish. Fold the foot in and grab the thigh and lift the chest. Oh, very good. And release the arm and the leg and lower down, wag your tail. Take a breath, sit back in child's pose, open your knees, crawl out in between your thighs, drop your forehead to the earth. Breathe. Notice the shift in your breath. Notice how your body adjusts and adapts and surrenders and relaxes. Paying attention to the physical form, letting other distractions be out of the way, and settling in with that nurturing aspect of focusing on the temple. Allows spirit to manifest, to vibrate, to circulate, to shift.
Another one of name.
Then easy, let's come on up. Come up onto all fours, wag the tail. Remember, the head is connected to the neck, the forefinger and thumb activate the armpits, the ribs, and the navel point stay towards the back ribs. Stretch your right foot back and curl the toe under. Keep your head in line. That's good. You don't want to over wrinkle your neck, but you don't want just to bobble around like one of those dolls. Breathing large, pressing on the heels of the hands so that that back calf gets stretched, the Achilles gets opened up. And then you just hinge forward so the shoulders are over the heel of the hand and the right leg floats up freely. Beautiful, stretch that back of the knee. Hare, bring that right foot forward. Then spin that right leg back and it's going to go across the knee on the ground and lift the chest and look over your shoulder, stretch that leg, be involved in this position. Let the bones, the muscles get strong, supporting this angled action. Spiraling, eyes open. See if you can see your heel. And then easy, lift that leg. Let it float and hinge all the way around to the side. Come off your right hip. Lower the foot down, little toe line, and open up that top arm. Right arm up to the sky. That's good. Stack the shoulders. Take the opportunity to turn your chin. If you run into your left shoulder blade, shoulder bone, rotate things away so that the fingers and the hands are involved and you've got space for your head. And then lower that right arm down easy. Lift the right leg, spin back off your tail and the left arm lifts up. Strong right arm. Use that as, stretch that leg, Will. Little more, that's great. Lift. And if you're in the mood, you can try and grab the ankle or the foot, lift the thigh. Ah. Breathe in, breathe out. Release. And lower on down and easy. Shake it out. Open the knees, sit back on your heels, walk your arms out long in front of you, drop your forehead to the earth. Feel that expansion of your ribs against your thighs. Oh, it's cute. You birds, be careful. There's cats in this house. Breathing, softening. Feel the beating of your heart, the quality of your breath. And easy. Come on up onto all fours. This is easy going to a little downward dog. Pull your elbows in. Glance specifically at your fingertips. Kind of pulse them to the earth. Wiggle your elbows. Squeeze the elbows towards each other. Forefinger and thumb are strong. Shoulder wings have sliding down to the waist. Curl the toes. Sit on your heels. Raise up into a crouch. Drop your ears between the upper arms. Lengthen the legs. Lift your bottom. Lift your heels. Push the earth away. Don't collapse in the upper body. Press. Strength. Pedal your heels now. Pedal the heels. Both heels come high, and now drop the heels and hinge into plank. You can go into side plank if you're in the mood. You can go into side plank, Fred. You can just start off by letting both legs go. Keep the hips high. That's good. And then come back into regular plank and then go to the other side. So just swing your Watusi, let the feet drop. You can hold your waist, you can stack the arm. You can stack the feet if you want. Come back into plank. Hang out there, breathe in, breathe out. And stay for 5 breaths. Elbows are strong, fingers are strong, inner thighs are working, belly is strong. Build up a little heat. Get ready for the fast, Freddy. Knees go down. The rest of us are schwitzing. Easy, bosoms down to the thumbs. Bottom is up, elbows are in. Slide your legs on back. Slide the hands forward. Come into Sphinx. Elbows are underneath the shoulders. Rock your hips. And then easy, slide your heart forward. Reach the feet back and look over your shoulder. See if you can see your heel. Good. Keep the head up, the chest up. Look over the other side. One side may be more friendly to move than the other. Back into the center. You know this sequence, front body opening, ribs are sliding away from the pubic bone, creating a great amount of space through your lower torso, the core of your body, heart is blazing forward. And then slowly low down till the bosoms reach the earth and stretch the arms back behind you. Legs are strong, bikini bottom is active. Lifting the chest up, stretching and strengthening the back. Come a little higher, Will. That's good. Arms are off the mat there, Fred. That's good. Like you're Superwoman or Wonder Woman or flying along. Oh, that's good. David, I can't see you, but I assume you're flying around down there. Good. Legs together, feet flat. I mean, ankles together. Squeeze that inner midline. Contain yourself. Keep your head up a little bit, Brenda. Two more breaths. One, two, and lower on down. Let the legs flop open. Bring your hands underneath your face. Heels are out. Turn your chin to the side or one cheek to the side and rest. Rest on your arms. Let the heels drop away so the lower back softens. Take a nice deep breath. The breath is moving into the back lungs. You can cross the other arms and turn the head the other direction. Relax, surrender to the support of the earth. Allow that magnificent circulation in the body to pulse, to feed. The breath moves into the very marrow of your bones, refreshing the oxygen, the prana. Beautiful. So the toes point, the big toes point towards each other, and the heels are dropped out to the outside of the carpet or the mat. There you go. Exactly. And then easy, go ahead and bring yourself so that the hands, head comes into the center and the hands slide underneath the shoulders and you sit back and hinge back into child's pose. You can dig your fingertips into the ground, kind of scoogee your knees together, do something about your stomach. Take your fingers and walk off to your right side. Give yourself a connection between your sit bones and your heels, glue them, and really stretch and open that whole side shoulder area. The right hand can slip back a little bit and press, so you get even a longer and more lengthening rotation of that left arm. Sit heavily in the left butt bone. And then easy, let's Michi march around. Support yourself with your fingertips as you Michi march around. Remember, you can take that right hand way far. The left hand can go back near your hip and kind of push. So that right arm is stretching. The bottom is connected to the heels. You'd be happy about it. Stretch that arm a little more. Stay low. Drop down, Freddie. Breathing. It's good if you golf. It's good if you drop things in the back of your car. It's good if you play sports. And easy. Massaging the body, Michi marching back into the center. Come up onto all fours. Couple of cat cows just to loosen it up. Make sure you open and close your mouth occasionally so the jaw gets eased. The jaw bones press, that hinge presses on the plates of your skull. So let's keep the mobility in our entire body. Exhale, cross your ankles, sit on back easy. Just do a little squeeze. Left leg is going to stretch out. Take the outside of your right thigh, pull the knee in and drop that foot to the outside. Lift the chest, drop the shoulders, press the left leg. Hold that right thigh right against the ribs. So when your shoulders drop and you breathe, you feel the expansion against the thigh. What? 15. Breathing easy. Let's go ahead and take that right arm and float it up. And arc back at an angle off your right hip. You can use your spider fingers. Press down on the fingers or the heel of the hand and lift the chest. Try and twist a little more. See if you can grab that thigh a little closer to your ribs, Will. Good. You can hug in a little more, Fred, with your elbow. Lengthen the neck and turn over the right shoulder. Okay. She okay? Is she okay? Oh, still? Now see if you can take that upper arm and hook it over the top of your thigh and your knee. Take the upper elbow, put it on the outside. That's good. Jab it and look back over your right shoulder. That's it. That's it. Good job. Lengthen the spine. Push through the left heel. Lift the heart. Breathe in, breathe out. Exaggerate your breath so you massage your belly. Your power. And then easy. Go ahead and release that arm. Come around. So that the right arm goes on your right leg and the left hand goes back behind you. Lengthen the spine and look over your left shoulder. Breathe in, breathe out. Good job. Feel the coolness or feel the warmth, depending on how your body is working, of the release of the squishing, the squeezing, the massaging. And then easy, round back again to the front. Take the foot, slide it forward, the leg. Oh no, it's always the same. One leg's longer than the other. You know how it is. Clear indication. Lift the arms up. Exhale, bow down. Three breaths. One, two, and three. Walk the hands on back. I know it's bad. Take the left leg and let's cross it over the right. You may need to grab your sticky buns off your sticky mat and pull the extra skin back behind you so you have a clear connection through your sit bones right on the earth. Hug that thigh into the waist, roll the shoulders, lengthen the neck. Easy, breathe in, breathe out. Good, and there's some strength on this foot. It's pressing on the earth to give you a freedom and a lengthening in the spine. Left arm reaches up to the sky, follow the gaze, arc back at 45 degrees, find the ground, spin the upper torso. You might have to round your back and grab your stomach and take it and put it over your thigh. If you have a lot of extra stomach, keep the thigh close to the ribs. Now wrap the elbow around the knee. See if you can make the right leg and the two shoulders in the same line even. Breathe in, breathe out. Ow. Now easy, let's see if we can exaggerate that spiral, that ringing effect of the central core of our body, all the organs being squeezed and squished and flushed. Take that elbow, see if you can go to the outside of the thigh, use it like a lever or a lever, bring the hand, other leg. Breathe in, breathe. Breathe in, breathe out. Angle, lengthen, slide that back hand closer to your tailbone. Good job. I can't believe you can do this so well. Good job. How are your guides and your gods doing? All the ghosts. What's happening back there? Backside of the body. Open eyes, open vision, asking for illumination by creating space, releasing any stagnation, any clogging, any slow movement. Exhale, flatten the belly, bring the arms around, easy. Hold onto the leg, take the right arm back behind you and open up the body. Oh, untwist, unwind. That's good, David, you go that way. We're going the other way. That's good, that's good, keep going. Look back at those shelves. Good, oh, rusty. Disappeared. Breathe in, breathe out. Two more breaths. And then easy, go ahead and bring that right arm. Take the leg, unhook it, stretch the legs out, grab your fanny, get it behind you, reach up, fold over, and go, oh my goodness, it really works. Good job. And remember to fake it till you make it. So you can always bend your knees if you need to, relax the shoulders. Sometimes people sit up and take their stomach literally and squeeze it out to the side. So you can lay over the top. You have to move the Cheetos. That's good. Are you further, Fred, than you were? That's so exciting. Will, what about you? You look like it. Good. And we have the flexi girls and David's just back in the fold. Good job. One more breath. Walk your hands back on in and easy. Scoot forward, roll down onto your backs and hug your knees into your chest. Squeeze the knees in. Massage a little bit. Grab the kneecaps. Spin the thigh bone around in the hip socket. Certainly be aware if you're if you begin to hear any clicking or clacking or creaking or cracking. I suppose not cracking, it's more like clicking. And then easy, reverse the knee spins in the other direction. and hop up into happy baby. Hold the outside feet. Get the back of the skull on the ground. Kneecaps into the armpits. Spread the feet wider than your body. Breathe in and breathe out. Happy baby. And then easy, straighten the legs. Hands go inside the calves and you pull that, slide the muscle so the toes reach towards the floor. Or you can hold the upper inside thighs. Try and let the weight of your arms or the strength of your arms make the stretch a little more robust. How's that? I don't think I've ever used that word, robust. I've heard other people, a robust stretch. Why not? Or V. Two more breaths. Go a little bigger, David. Live it up. Now slip your hands to the outside of your legs and squeeze the legs together up towards the sky. Let your hands come directly behind your head. Lace your fingers. Lift your chest up. And your head off the ground, elbows flop open, legs are right up there. And let's just do a little bit of our abdominal exhale. That sounded like an invitation for something else rather than abdominal strengthening. Flat belly, forceful exhale, flat belly. If you want to work a little further, you can lever your legs off your body 6 inches. Work the low belly. Try not to bob the head and try not to rip the head off the neck. Keep the elbows open, the chest up, and exhale through your low gut. How about 30 more? 30 days, half September. Last 10. Inhale, hold the breath, arms up. Exhale, fold the knees in, lay the head down. Stretch your right leg up. Hold the left leg in at your chest. Roll that right foot around, tracing the face of the analog clock. Reverse counterclockwise. Any clicking or clacking, full range of motion for that foot on the ankle, on the leg. Shoulders are relaxed, head is heavy on the earth. Pull that knee, that left knee into the chest, drop the shoulders, push through the heel and lower that right leg out far away from you, 7 counts. Lengthen that right leg, om 4. Now point the foot, om 5. Om 6, lengthen the leg. Om 7, heel is on the ground. Lift your head up, turn your head to the left. Take your left arm out at shoulder level. Pull the left leg across the body to the ground. You may have to scoop back onto your hip pad and let that top arm come onto your eyes, that left arm onto your eyes. Get the left knee down on the ground so you have a spinal twist. The right leg is lengthened. Opening up through the left armpit, stretching the left ribs, breathing in and breathing out. If you're lucky, no, not lucky, fortunate, or in need of, you may even get a small spinal adjustment. On your exhale, you're going to flatten the belly, roll back onto your back, bend both knees, realign the hip so it's in line with the shoulders, and bounce the hips down on the ground. Bounce that pelvis, that chalice, down, 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 down. Break it up. Anything that's caught, achy, solidified, calcified, just bounce, bounce, bounce. Circulate, circulate. Hug the knees in again to the chest. Wrap the arms around the shins. Hold that right leg in towards the body and stretch the left leg up to the sky. Rotate the left foot on the ankle, tracing the face of the analog clock. Keeping the back of the skull on the ground, trying to glue your wing bones to the ground. Reverse the circle of the left foot. Full range of motion. Notice for yourself what the difference is. Come back into the center. Inhale, exhale, reaching through the left heel. That left leg is strong and long. Om two, lower down slowly. Om three, om four, point the foot. Om five, om six. Heel drops onto the earth, om seven. Right thigh is at the ribs. Lift your head up and look to the right. Let your right arm go out at shoulder level. Pull the right leg across the body. Scoop back a little bit on your hip. Bring the right arm to your eyes. Let the left hand weight down that right knee. Complete spinal spiral. Good. You can always flip your hand, that right hand down, and rub your lower back if you wish, or knee around with your knuckles into your hip socket. David, roll all the way over to the ground. Roll towards your windows. No, towards the other way. Yeah. Good job. You can let the right hand go with you up onto your head or on your rump. You can pat your rump. I love you. I do. Breathing. Good job. Nice. There you go, Brenda. Soften that right shoulder a little bit. So close, the girls. And then easy on the exhale, the belly flattens against the backbone and you roll back onto your backs. Unhook the legs, bounce the hips down on the ground. Boom, 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 boom. Knees are bent, feet are on the ground. Just bounce. Bounce that sacrum. And then easy, squeeze both knees into the chest. Put the arms out easy and just roll the feet, the knees side to side, softly without any anxiety. Let your arms anchor you and let the knees just roll side to side down onto the ground, continuing that ringing effect. Coming back into the, oh, that's so nice. That's such a good massage. Nice, Will. Go a little deeper down to the ground, Fred. That's good, David. Go a little slower and all the way knees down to the ground. Good, and then give yourselves a hug. Hug those knees in there. Hold the knees in nice and easy, and then easy. Stretch the arms and legs up to the sky. Lift your head. Pulse your fingers. Pulse your toes. Inhale. Squeeze everything. And exhale. Lay your body out easy. Either in a big starfish or both hands can come softly onto your lower belly. You can find yourself in a real shavasana or a corpse pose on your mat. Or you can take up more space, legs a little further apart, arms a little wider, Eyes soft, body easy. Take a nice deep breath and let yourself relax. The toes usually flop open. The lips become plump, the eyes sink heavily into the sockets. The large muscles drop away from the bones. Breathe easy. Let the gaze meander through your interior landscape. Let yourself find that stillness, that ease. It's always a sense of curiosity, the softening of the body. How well do you surrender to control? How well do you surrender to support? How honestly can you relax for a moment as the body naturally rebalances itself? Can you create in your imagination that sense of hollowness from the soles of your feet through your pelvic bowl, the palms of your hands, your inner ears, the crown of your head, which tingles and trembles with that yearning for conscious contact. We hail to the divine within. We hail to the divine aspects of ourselves. We allow ourselves as a spiritual being, as an energetic force, as an energetic igniter, as an energetic receptor. We look for the illumination. I found something sweet I would read to you. It says, let us open up our natures, throw wide the doors of our hearts, and let in the sunshine of goodwill and kindness. So that's easy. And pull ourselves back into the vessel. Bring ourselves into this sweetness, this sweet, supple, strong, variable temple, our vessel, our chariot, our ride. Let's bring our awareness into the breath and let the breath draw us back into the body. So the breath goes to the navel point and expands, gets larger and flows to the fingers and flows to the toes. Mm-hmm. I slide the thumbs across the fingertips.
And help free yourself.
Connecting the nervous system. And then easy, let's slide the arms out, up and overhead as we bring them, first to our hearts. We gather in this gratitude and we receive grace always.
There's a naive man.
Lace the fingers, twine the fingers. Now we roll the palms up and overhead onto the mat. palms facing away from the crown, continuing that extension. Step the straight legs together so they touch. Point your toes, push your heels, flutter your eyelashes, wiggle through your hips, move your lips, and just go, yeah. Hare Rama. Hug in, exhale, give yourselves a hug as the knees squeeze into the chest. Squeeze the knees in, give yourself a hug. Roll off to your left side. We move swiftly towards that full moon. Press up to a seated position that's comfortable for you. Yep.
Only.
You and the Great Spirit. Become lovers, sweet lovers. Stretch the arms up and overhead. Baby finger and thumbs. Open up to the chalice. Slide on down the heart line, receiving through the smooth brow, crown of your head, through your chalice, through your cup. Exhale the fingertips together and bow the brow towards the heart. And in this ancient and sacred greeting, we know the sameness of our breath, the sameness of our blood. We welcome, we honor, we greet that incandescent, dancing Great Spirit within ourselves and others. We thank ourselves for being present and a part of. Can you still hear me?
Now we can.
Now you can. Good. Okay. Thanks. Spin risk. Thank you so much. That's to bring you back to the reality of the earth.